Good afternoon, and thanks first a lot. I want to thank for this invitation and for the opportunity to present to the EUPATHI Group another European project, the ECRAN project. Let me start before with the. Is the green one? Okay, push. Let me start with some general consideration that come out from the activity and the experience of the work done in my lab in this year in the field of patient and public involvement. And this general consideration support in some way the ECRAN project. The first is that promote the participation is very important. A research agenda, working group, ethics committee, commission needs in their group to have patient consumer empowered. And also initiative aim to support research and raise independent funds and investment are very important. It's also important and always the participation to these activities are checking in terms of impact of the activity to avoid that participation of patient, consumer or their representative and only a formal presence. It must be a substantial presence to this group. It's also important to have access to scientific evidence, independent information, clinical research protocols. I think that most of us know the All Trials Initiative, but also is very important for consumer, patient, and their representative to have tools to assess the quality of this kind of scientific evidence. It's important to organize and participate in the program of empowerment. We discussed along during this morning, and this is important that are organized by independent institution. It's also important in the field of patient and public involvement to explore methods, different methods, to increase the active participation to the debate. For example, organizing consensus conference or jury or citizen. But also important, this is the last point, is for the scientific community overcome the difficulties in upsetting the consumer as interlocutors with a particular and very important experience. At the end of the slide, there are some logos of the project where we are involved. One of these is the ECRAN project. ECRAN project aim to develop tools to communicate key messages about independent multinational clinical research. There are two different targets of the project. The first is the citizen, patient organization, and society in general. And the second is healthcare professional, researchers, or policy makers. The clinical research is intended not just pharmacological research, but also in other kind of trial, for example, trials of device, rehabilitation, strategies of assistance, or counseling intervention, and is supported by the European, with the founder of the European Community. The project started last September, it is 2 years long. The principal key message of the project are these 4 points. The first is the importance to public understanding of need and the basic principle of clinical trials, fostering active involvement participation in trials, but also not just in the trial, but also in the trial design. The second point is the need for independent trials driven by healthcare needs, in particular outcome of interest of patient, not just outcome of interest of academia or pharmaceutical company. It's very important to need for the transparency and optimal use of the data to allow the use in analysis and meta-analysis, but also to prevent bias in presenting and analyze the results. And finally, one of the key messages important of the project is to the need of multinational cooperation, in particular at the European level, to avoid the replication of clinical trials and to taking in advance the Europe population size and diversity. This project is there are 9 different partners in the project, and in particular I want to underline that there are 2 outstanding groups that represent citizen and patient. The first is the Cochrane Consumer Collaboration, and the second is the European AIDS Treatment Group that is always present in the EUPATI group. The key message, these 4 key messages will be addressed using different communication tools. Some of these are a website, an online database of open communication resources. We already collect more than 100 communication tools around the European countries. We are already finished, unfortunately was impossible to show today, we'll be ready in a month or 2 months, an animated film on clinical trials. And we are also working on an interactive online package, including serious game, podcast, and videos, to attract the young European citizen. And then we also want to develop a sibling website on the basis of testament treatment. This is a project developed by Sir Ian Chalmers in UK. And finally, have a collaborative work with journalists, in particular science journalists. The project, as you can see on this scheme, we will finish with the end of after 2 years with an international event on multinational clinical trials that will collect and present to the community all the materials, all the activity done. Each work package of the project take advance each of the other, and then all the activity and the tools will be collected in website. All the tools will be under Creative Commons license, so we'll be able to collect, to link with other, with a singular link or whatever, and will be free and available for all the European group. Most of the activity will be translated in the 6 European languages that cover 2 on 4 of the European population, but the film and inventory materials and tool will be available also in the 23 European languages. This is the mock-up of the website we are just working on. The idea was to have the flags of the different country, and under the flag to have some material in the original language. This is very important for some particular countries, and also facilitate, of course, the reading and the approach to these tools. And the most part of the document will be translated in six languages. On the bottom there is the first draft of the inventory of material. Will be a database that is possible to look to find a document through keywords. Finally, this is my final slide. There are some pictures of the film that we produce with the Bozzetto Studio that is specialized in this animation that very funny, nice, and easy to follow. And these are some, of course, some of pictures extracted for the film. One, for example, regarding the point that each protocol must be approved by an ethics committee that is independent of the people that support the study. This one is regarding the randomization that was explained like drawing lots. And finally, another picture regards the idea that the treatment must, is not enough that the treatment is statistically significant, but must be a treatment that really improve the health of a patient. This, of course, is a very quickly overview of the project. All the document will be available, and of course, we are very interested to have collaboration at the local, of course, but the European level. Thank you very much for your attention.